Hello everyone, I am Rusha Mukherjee, a student of Shwendranath Law College and currently interning with Lex & Company. Today I am going to talk about the fixation of fair rent. The controller can, on application made to him, either by the landlord or by the tenant in the prescribed manner, fix the fair rent in respect of any premises in accordance with the provisions of this Act. We know that the fair rent fixation is a very, very important phenomenon. The fair rent for a year in respect of any premises constructed and let out in the year 1984 shall be fixed on the basis of the annual payment of an amount equal to 6 3/4% per annum of the aggregate amount of the actual cost of construction and the market price of the land on the date of the commencement of construction. The explanation provides: the cost of construction of the premises shall include the cost of water supply and sanitary and electric installation and shall be determined with due regard to the rates adopted for the purpose of estimate by the Public Works Department of the State Government for the area concerned. The controller may allow or disallow the variation of estimates up to 10%. Having regard to the nature of the premises, provided that while calculating the market value of the site on which the premises are constructed, the controller shall take into account only the portion of the site on which the premises were constructed and 60% of the portion of the vacant land, if any, appertaining to such premises, the excess portion of the vacant land being treated as animity. Where a tenancy subsists for 20 years or more, the respect of the premises constructed in or before the year 1984, the fair rent shall be determined by adding to the rent as on 1st July 1976 not more than 3 times and then deducting the increase, if any, in the matter provided in Schedule 2, or by accepting the existing rent if such rent is more than the increased rent determined according to that schedule. Where the tenancy subsists for 10 years or more but less than 20 years in respect of the premises constructed in or before the year 1984, the fair rent shall be determined by adding to the rent as on 1st July 1986 not more than 2 times and then deducting the increase, if any, in the manner provided in Schedule 3, or by accepting the existing rent if such rent is more than the increased rent determined according to that schedule. Where a tenancy subsists for 20 years or more in respect of the premises constructed in or before the year 1984 and used for the commercial purpose, the fair rent shall be determined by adding the rent as on 1st July 1976 5 times, or by accepting the existing rent if such rent is more than the increased rent determined under the subsection. Where any tenancy subsists for 10 years or more but less than 20 years in respect of the premises constructed in or before 1984 and used for commercial purposes, the fair rent shall be determined by adding to the rent as on 1986 3 times, or by accepting the existing rent if such rent is more than the increased rent determined under this subsection. The term fair rent has been defined in Section 2B of the Act and means the rent fixed under Section 17 by the controller. However, the provisions of Section 17 does not provide or define what is meant by fair rent. The section only prescribes the mode and manner of fixation of rent. In Eckenbach's Mulla vs. Dharampal, the court held that fair rent is the rent which is fair for both the landlord and the tenant, and must also reason of conscience to the judge. Again, where the parent of the landlord and the rent fair to the tenant work out differently, the mean between them could be fair and reasonable. Fair rent does not depend on the agreement between the parties, and for that purpose, the agreement is irrelevant. Either the landlord or the tenant may apply for the fixation of fair rent to the controller. According to Rule 8 of the West Bengal Premises Tenancy Rules 1999, such an application shall be made to the controller, stating fully the facts of the case and provisions under which the fixation of fair rent is claimed. We know that the fair rent is a very important part for the landlord and tenant relationship, because if the rent is too high, then it will be of disadvantage to the tenant, and if it is too low, then the landlord will be at loss. So the controller and ultimately the courts play a very vital role in determining the fair rent that will be of the benefit for both the tenant and the landlord. That's it for today. Have a nice day, and if you like the video, please subscribe to the channel. Stay happy, stay safe.